come together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. As we gather before our God, we call to mind our sins and so prepare to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Enable us, we pray, Almighty God, to proclaim the power of the risen Lord, that we, who have received the pledge of his gift, may come to possess all he gives when it is fully revealed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and one mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them and bring the proceeds of the sale and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to their own needs. Thus Joseph, also named by the apostle Barnabas, which is translated son of encouragement, a Levite, a Cypriot by birth, sold a piece of property that he owned, then brought the money and put it at the feet of the apostles. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is King. He is robed in majesty.
The Lord is King. He is robed in majesty.
The Lord is King in splendor robed. Robed is the Lord and girded about.
The Lord is King, he is robed in majesty.
And he has made the world firm, not to be moved. Your throne stands firm from of old, from everlasting you are, O Lord.
The Lord is King, he is robed in majesty.
Your decrees are worthy of trust indeed. Holiness befits your house, O Lord, for length of days.
The Lord is King, he is robed in majesty.
The
Jesus said to Nicodemus, you must be born from above. The wind blows where it wills, and you can hear the sound it makes, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus answered and said to him, how can this happen? Jesus answered and said to him, you are the teacher of Israel, and you do not understand this. Amen. Amen, I say to you, we speak of what we know, and we testify to what we have seen. But you people do not accept our testimony. If I tell you about earthly things and you do not believe, how will you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has gone up to heaven except the one who has come down from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the desert, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, so that everyone who believes in him may have eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Every time I hear that reading from Acts, and we hear it once a year at Easter time, I think of just how incomprehensible that is, that individuals would be so convicted, if you will, by what the apostles were preaching, that they'd be willing to say, okay, everything I have is for the good of the community. Here it is. Take it. Use it as you will. I only need enough to survive. But the gospel, I think, supports where that incredible, unthinkable action comes from. As Jesus and Nicodemus continue their conversation, Jesus is trying to convince him and help him understand that when you're filled with the Spirit that will be released as a result of the Son of Man's death and resurrection, when you're filled with that, you will do anything. You'll do it for the sake of God. You'll do it for the sake of others. So I guess, after all, it's not as incomprehensible or ridiculous as it may seem to us. Think of it. Think of your best day. Think of the day when everything just seems right, that you're willing to do whatever it is. That's God's Spirit at work in you. And God's Spirit does continue to work, continues to work very powerfully. Talking to someone recently, and they made the comment how the devil has wrapped his arms, if you will, around the world, and I felt so much in despair when they said that. I thought, how impossible that is. The devil may be trying to get at things, but certainly God would never allow that. We, people of faith, would not allow that. There is much, much more good going on than there is bad. And that's the result of the Spirit. So trust in the Spirit. Have those good days. Wrap your arms around others. Where the wind blows, we do not know where it comes from and where it goes. We don't know where it comes from, but we know this. Jesus Christ has died, risen from the dead, and has sent the Spirit to dwell with us, to enable us, to empower us, to bring good news to others. By God's Holy Spirit, we join our voices together in prayer this day of all of us.
We pray for leaders of the church, and may the Holy Spirit magnify the power of God. Jesus Christ. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world, may the Lord have mercy on the suffering and the trials of all people. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering from physical or spiritual pain, may the healing power of Christ bring them relief. We pray for the sick and the suffering, especially for Fred Burkhart, John Catarino, Bob Christian, Vanessa Curry, Danny Firth, Mike Firth, Floss Firth, Deja Furtney, Ron Hilke, Julianne Jenkins, Dan Lane, Dan Klein, Jonathan Lorkowski, Tom Lorkowski, Joyce Moore, Denise Petras, Laura Katroki, Ray Rich, Brooke Russell, Carol Staley, Katrina Shunk, Paula Simmons, Janet Treat, Gurney Wozinski, and Claire Whitus. And for the victims and survivors of abuse in our church and beyond, for accountability, justice, and healing throughout the church, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this worship community, may we grow in compassion and love through the grace of the Holy Spirit and the example of Jesus. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they be brought into the light of the risen Lord in heaven. And for those who have recently died, and especially this morning, we pray for James and Syke, for whom this Mass is being offered. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions that remain deep in the silence of our hearts and our minds, for those written in our prayer notebook, and for those that we have been asked to pray for through our renewal, recommitment, initiative. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Ever faithful God, hear us. We turn to you in our need and hasten to give answer. For we pray this and all things in the name of your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine of the vine, fruit of the vine,
and work with human beings, it will become our spiritual journey. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore overcome with paschal joy. Every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory, as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the
so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings, and pour out on them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though we once were lost and could not approach you, you love us with the greatest love. For your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death, and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth, to become a lasting sign of your covenant, he desired to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. As he ate with them, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to them, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, and once more giving thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith, we proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead. Looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer you, who are our faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim, who reconciles to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that, by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and one chalice, they may be gathered into one body in Christ, who heals every division. Please keep us always in communion of mind and heart. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Edward, our Bishop, help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom, until the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we humbly commend to your mercy. Then freed at last from the womb of corruption, and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, pray.
should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The Christ had to suffer and rise from the dead, and so enter into his glory. Hallelujah.
The body of Christ.
Amen. The body of Christ. this most holy exchange by which you have redeemed us, and bring your help in this present life.